What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory, where safety is number one priority. And today we're going to put to the test 5 vintage gadgets. Let's see what I got this time. For the first gadget, I got this very unique chopper. It even says on it, stainless steel chopper, vintage. Does it say the date? I don't think so. But anyways, the way it works, boom, it's print loaded in here. And whenever I press it here, one blade will close and the other ones will hit whatever you're gonna be chopping. Makes sense, right? Okay, let's try to chop up this stuff. Kinda don't work that well on these giant cucumber things. It chops it, but not all the way, and then you'll have to remove it. Also, it's too thick. But it's kinda makes sense what we are trying to do, right? It's probably made mostly for lettuce like that. And you put it in a bowl and then you chop it up inside of the bowl. So I got a little square bowl right here. Stick everything in there. And let's see how well it's going to slice and dice all that stuff. Okay, let's see. No way, it's actually chopping. Chopping it really good if it's big leaves of something and you need to make a bunch of salad. Almost too good. Check this out. Well, probably not to do it in a bowl, but there you go. My salad is way chopped up, too much. Let's try this again, but not as so aggressive. I'll tell you what, guys, it works so well. Check this out. I have chopped salad, chopped lettuce. Pretty awesome. And this time, because I laid it all out, it didn't chop up too much. So very nice. Couple more leaves over here. And then I'm gonna go down to the carrots. I'll close it like that. Boom, this is awesome. I wonder why they don't still make it. It was actually pretty fun. Let's try to chop up carrots. Okay, let's say we need to chop up carrots bite sizes. Let's see what it looks like. Wow, this is actually works pretty good. On the thicker side, you gotta go a little bit faster, but yeah, definitely chops it bite size. It's really good. For the next gadget, I got here vintage ice crusher. There is 4 really sharp, what do you call this, peaks, and there is right here a little piece that you can lock it in and crush the ice like that. And as you can see, the ice is being crushed really good. Whoops. But in case you're worried that you're going to hit the ice and it gets stuck like that, that is why this design makes it not to get stuck, as you can see. You just crush it instantly. Probably best to do it in a cup or something, so that way you can crush up lots of ice. Makes a bit of mess to do it in a cup, but makes sense, right? If I keep going like that, look at that, big cubes of ice goes into small pieces. Maybe I put too much of ice. So you know what, if, make sure you put way less ice. That way in your own cup you can make lots of crushed ice. There you go. Actually works, look at that. It's like snow now. Awesome. You know what? I'm definitely going to use this gadget. Put it by the bar, piece of history, and actually works as well. Okay, let's try this again without making any mess. I put only 5 pieces of ice. Let's try to crush it. Maybe go, don't as go as violently. One still fell out. But it's definitely crushed it really well. You know what, this time I definitely made a lot less mess. Maybe 2 pieces came out, but it crushed the ice really well. Maybe if I put it like this now. Yeah, it doesn't even stuck and clean the ice out. Awesome. Some of the ice gets stuck in between, as you can see. And you got yourself crushed ice. Pretty awesome. For the next gadget, I got here Vantage Apple Core. There's Leo Markets explaining who it was made by and what it does. There's a blade inside of it. I do not know why it's bended sideways. Is it bent on purpose like that, or somebody bent it when they were trying to slice up the apple? Let's find out. Looks like this gadget made for the bigger apples. We're gonna put it like that. Whoa, no way. Wow, you know what? That blade there is on purpose. Then you pull this backwards, I guess. Whoa, this is awesome. Now, how do I take out the apple core? I have no idea. That's the problem. Do I push it to this side? No, it might break. Oh, there you go. You can push it backwards. Nice. One and two. So the only minus about this apple core, it's kind of hard to release the core. But you know what? Let's try this two more times. I have here another big apple. See what happens. It's kind of spins because of that blade inside there. And you gotta go all the way down, right? I might have missed it a little bit. There you go. And then pull it out. Beautiful. Once again, I can't believe this. And then you just push it backwards. There you go. You can just push it backwards if you can. Kind of. So yes, it works really good. But pushing backwards part is not so much. I guess now you can take this out. There you go. Let's try one more apple. Put it in. And down and turn. Definitely takes a little bit of a muscle, but look how perfect that is. And then just pull it out. Beautiful apple core right here, that's for sure. The only problem is taking this apple out from here. For the next gadget, you got here can stucker. So this some kind of lids, and looks like comes with them four total. And as you can see, regular cans, soups and all that kind of stuff, and then even soda cans with the other cans. So you got right here plastic rings, come in a 4-pack. So in case you want to stack your cans, so that way you don't have to worry about them falling, you put one like that, put second one on top, another one, third one on top. Makes sense, right? The only problem though, it's not really that well stacking, as you can see. It's like wiggles everywhere. To where if I take off these plastic pieces and stack these cans, it actually stuck by itself way better than with this gadget. Again, if I put this gadget in, you see how much it's wiggling? So yeah, somebody thought it was a good idea, but not so much. They just developed cans to where they're stackable anyways. I don't know if it was always this way. It doesn't look like this gadget is that old, so probably don't have to use this gadget anyway. Look at that, it's sliding all over the place now. Without the gadget, stuck so well for the cans, it's not going anywhere. And the description right here stops your can from falling, keeps your cabinet and pantry organized. But again, do I really need it? Whoops. It doesn't really fall either. And it stacks well with the gadget. One, two. It's less standable. For the next gadget, I got here egg cooker. This looks like made from aluminum or something like that with the plastic handle on top. And it says eggs, 1 to 2, 2 to 4. I guess how much water you fill it up. Let me show it to you closer. I'm not really exactly sure how to use these lines. But yeah, pretty cool, isn't it? What I'm excited about, every time you put the eggs into the boiling water, you leave it for like 7 minutes. It's soft boil eggs, 10 minutes medium, and 12 minutes hard boil eggs. But when you drop an egg inside of the pot, chances are you're going to crack at least one of them, even if you try to put it with a spoon. I've had problem with that. So instead, you can just put your eggs down here. 1, 2, 6. Looks like 6 eggs, no problem. How cool is that? So now, instead of dropping one egg at a time, also time consuming, and you place in one egg 30 seconds or almost a minute sooner before the last egg you're going to put. So they're going to cook uneven. With this egg cooker, you're going to place all the eggs at the same time in the boiling water so they cook evenly. At least this is the idea. Next, I'm boiling water. Once it's boiled, I'm gonna place the eggs inside there just to test it. Did I fill up the water good? I did. Not really sure what those markings do. Let me know in comments below. What are you supposed to have them for? But there you go. It said on this right here. Now it's boiling really, really hot. I can just place it easily. Boom. You know what? I think you don't even supposed to do that. I think there is going to be a whistle. So I could have just added to the line and wait till it start whistling instead of boiling the water. It actually supposed to whistle. So this is fresh cold water, and then you stick it in there, and let's say I put right here in the middle. We'll come back and see how well it does. Guess what? It's actually whistling. How cool is that? So I guess it's meaning it's boiled. I don't know if I actually followed their direction, but still very, very unique gadget, that's for sure. By the way, I switched the pots because this one was too small. Anyways, now I can take all the eggs out all at once. So easy, convenient. Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below what do you think about this video. Don't forget the thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.